welcome back to Indigo Smokes Tarot. I am doing a energy check-in for the rest of this month for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, North and South Node. So anyone with dominant Virgo in the chart, this reading may resonate for you. I'm going to start off with an oracle message, and then we'll get into the tarot cards, and I'll probably close with some oracle guidance. Divine insight, divine guidance for the collective of Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Lunar nodes. Those with dominant Virgo energy, what is the overall guidance or message for Virgo? Okay, let's do the cards. I do see a lot of good energy. Alright, we have the Unicorn, Good Fortune, Friendship, the Harlequin, the Talisman, Destined to Succeed. So those are good energies. Bottom of the deck, the forces of nature favor you. So who knows, maybe you'll have a happier reading in regards to like love and romance. It says passion and romance wait, or just a happy period, okay? I'm going to leave these out. I'm going to take half of this deck and turn it into reverse because it's all in the upright right now. So, can we get divine insight, divine guidance for the collective of Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Lunar nodes? Half of it goes into reverse. Divine guidance, divine insight for the collective of Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Lunar nodes. One more shuffle. Divine insight, divine guidance, clarity for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Moon nodes. Can I get three cards of insight for Virgo? Reverse Three of Swords, healing energy, that's good. Can I get two more cards for Virgo? The Nine of Wands, okay. Having been through a lot but continuing to push forward, push through. The Wounded Warrior energy, but ultimately healing. Can I get one more card of insight and guidance for Virgo? Ten of Wands. Yes. Whatever you have been going through up until this point, Virgo, I do feel like you are at the end of it. Alright? Whether this is a burden that you're going to drop or whether this is just you pushing forward to the completion of a particular cycle or situation in your life, I do see healing. I like that this is in the reverse and that this was the first card. Bottom of the deck is the reverse Page of Cups. So once again, you have most likely been experiencing, or this could just be something that maybe you're reflecting on from your past, but either way, there have been feelings of sadness, disappointment, maybe even dealing with some emotional immaturity, either in yourself or in other people. But ultimately, like I said, healing is here, so I'm going to leave this out. Can we clarify the reverse Three of Swords for Virgo? All right, the reverse Hangman. Okay, so there may have been some resistance in regards to this healing process, but ultimately I do feel like this is the pervasive energy. The reverse Hangman can talk about resistance to surrendering, you know, not wanting to surrender to a new perspective or just being in an uncomfortable space and kind of just feeling trapped, you know. For a lot of you, this healing energy could have been very hard for you to maintain. You probably had a bit of a back and forth between, you know, obviously healing and then not feeling like you've healed. And just, you know, healing isn't a linear process. You know, it happens in waves. It happens in cycles. You can't really force it or rush it. So, clarify the reverse Three of Swords, reverse healing energy for Virgo. Healing from the drama, healing from whatever conflict that caused this heartbreak, but also you could, for some of you, I do feel like you may have been kind of trapped in like the vicious cycle of feeling trapped within your pain for a long time, which caused a lot of inner conflict for you, but ultimately, I feel like you're moving forward from the energy. Like I said, this Ten of Wands, like, either you're dropping a burden or you are pushing through to the end of this particular cycle or situation. Can we clarify the reverse Three of Swords, Nine of Wands energy for Virgo? Alright, Seven of Pentacles, slow and steady progress. What is the Seven of Pentacles green for Virgo? Slow and steady progress as far as like financial recovery and just overcoming the hardships that you've been going through, even if they're not financial. Whatever this heartbreak was, it could have obviously, like I said, I feel like you maybe had some issues with your healing process, feeling left out in the cold, dealing with issues of not feeling good enough, not feeling worthy enough, and you know, any other financial troubles or hardships that you may have dealt with. Slowly but surely overcoming that particular energy and the situation or people that caused you to feel that way. Can we clarify the Nine of Wands for Virgo? And I do feel like for a lot of you, your energy is guarded. Or has been up until this point. Then we have the Queen of Swords, Libra energy, like I said. The Queen of Swords is very no-nonsense. Like, she's been through so much shit. Like, she has the wisdom that's hard-earned. You know, having dealt with a lot of sorrow and grief and heartbreak. You know, it heartens her a little bit, but it also gives her wisdom beyond her years, no matter how old she is. So like I said, I do feel like you guys have been through a lot, and you're a lot wiser and sharper for it, even though your healing process has or is a little bit wavering. Like I said, this is a push through kind of energy, even though, you know, you may be a little tired, you may be a little bit worn from the experience. Ultimately, I do feel like your energy is pretty solid here, and like I said, you are pushing through to the completion of this or the dropping of this burden. Can we clarify the Queen of Swords for Virgo? For others of you, maybe this is an energy you're dealing with external to you that can maybe be helping you through this process. Like I said, you can have someone, if this Queen of Swords energy isn't you, you could just have someone in your energy who is maybe giving you wisdom beyond their years. You know, they've been where you are, so maybe they're able to help you overcome this hardship, this ongoing battle that you've been going through. Excuse me. I've had a Queen of Swords for Virgo. One card. Okay. Page of Pentacles. Okay, so starting over, going towards something new, something solid, something that you can grow and build with. Like I said, that Seven of Pentacles is slow and steady progress, so planting seeds in regards to a new situation, the beginnings of something new, and just being very focused on that. Okay, for a lot of you, this is like focusing on something that you want to build, or focusing on your finances in regards to just trying to, you know, distract yourself from what it is that you have been feeling. Or this is just you after your healing process. You are now focused on the things that you can control, the things that you can build and sustain, and you're planting seeds in regards to that, whether that is a business, whether that is just more financial security, whatever that is for you, building that and planting the seeds for it. Okay. And for those of you with children, focusing more on your children as well. Can we clarify the Nine of Wands, Ten of Wands energy for Virgo? And Five of Cups. So a lot of emotional issues you're working through, a lot of grief. If this is an energy that you're still currently in, try not to run from it, okay? We do have two fives here. As challenging as it may be, and as much inner conflict as it may trigger for you, try and work through the energy instead of running away from it, all right? Why is this Five of Cups here for Virgo? And like I said, the pain has been weighing very, very heavy on you. Everything that you've been through weighing very heavy on you. Because I think we have all fives here now. So 555. Having been through just a lot of chaos, a lot of shifts, a lot of change, a lot of heartache, a lot of trials and tribulations. Why is the Five of Cups here for Virgo? Yeah. First Five of Swords. So once again, surrender to your process, okay? The external conflict, if you can, just distance yourself from it. Wow, you have all fives here. I say for a lot of you, there could be a need to just like go the peaceful route, just for yourself, just for your own mental and emotional health, because all the fives here just symbolize a lot of like too much conflict, too much drama, and this is a lot for you to adjust to, this is a lot for you to deal with, and the best way that you can to eliminate anything that's making your journey harder unnecessarily, I say just try and cut ties with it or distance yourself from it to the best of your capabilities. Bottom of the deck was Four of Pentacles, so definitely protecting your energy, focusing on your security, your finances, your kids, your home, yourself. Can we clarify the Ten of Wands for Virgo? Six of Swords. So once again, like for a lot of you, it's very difficult to transition forward. It's very, it can be very difficult for you to let go of the past, let go of the baggage. Okay, finding issues with transitioning and moving forward to something new and leaving the troublesome energy behind. That could be very, very difficult for you. But like I said, just clarifying the Ten of Wands, you're almost there. Whether, like I said, that is dropping a burden, or whether it's just you are completing whatever this tumultuous cycle has been thus far, and you're adjusting to the change that that all of these fives have brought or are bringing to you. Can we clarify the reverse Page of Cups for Virgo? Reverse Three of Cups. Okay, so for some of you, this could have been, you know, in regards to a particular friendship that you maybe fell out with a friend, but either way, this would definitely be like a personal connection, whether it's a friend, whether it's family, whether it's a lover, dealing with emotional immaturity, or maybe someone being envious of you, or any of those kind of issues that can surface in a relationship that causes it all to fall apart, that causes, you know, someone maybe to feel like, you know, someone that you're in a connection with, or like a friendship, like maybe they don't have your back, or maybe they left you out in the cold, or maybe they betrayed you, or maybe you, you know, were associated with a frenemy. It could be any of those things, and just the disappointment that comes with that, and having to deal with the emotional immaturity of others, or the emotional coldness of others, and just the heartbreak that comes with relationships and just living life. It can be very hard for you to release this, but I do see that it has been or is weighing very, very heavy on you, and it would be more beneficial to you for you to work through the energy and work on releasing it, and, you know, not carrying it with you into this new cycle of life. Okay. Can we clarify the Seduction card for Virgo? It's crazy because, I mean, the heartbreak energy is here, but I don't see the love energy here. That's crazy. And then the Lovers comes out. So for some of you, it was. For some of you, it was. This could be talking about just considering that the Seduction card is a kind of a good card for me. For some of you, this could be like new relationships or a love connection on the horizon for you, which is really, really good. And that could be why, you know, the energy that's weighing so heavily on you, the message is kind of like to work through that and release it, that way you're not taking it into new friendships, new romantic relationships, and the new path that you're taking. Can we clarify this Lover's energy for Virgo? Is this good? Is this bad? Is this a relationship? Is this a path? Clarify the Lover's for Virgo. Yeah, so this is something new for you, okay? Whether this is a new path, or whether this is a new friendship, whether this is a new relationship, something exciting, something inspiring, something that you feel very passionate about, most likely another person, because we do have Seduction here. So for a lot of you, this could be a new relationship, all right? So do your best not to carry the past baggage with you, all right? Heal so that you don't bleed on people that didn't cut you in the future, okay? Clarify the Green Man for Virgo. Swords. This, it almost came out, and then it decided to just do the damn thing. So the Two of Swords, it can talk about, you know, fear and anxiety, you know. You talk about feeling torn, but with this clarifying the Green Man card, I do feel like this is kind of like a need to not let your fear, your worry over the past or your past baggage, or don't become so emotionally closed off. Okay, don't allow your fear, your anxiety, or the emotions that, you know, the past has inflicted you with to make you become guarded or detached from this new energy that's on the horizon for you. Okay, what is this Two of Swords energy for Virgo? I don't know how it came out, so I'm gonna put it back. What was the bottom of the deck energy? Shit, I don't remember. Can I clarify the clarify the Two of Swords for Virgo. Reverse Three of Pentacles. So once again, don't become guarded because of things that didn't work out in the past. Okay. Don't try to bury yourself in work or focusing on, you know, your money. Don't run away from your feelings. Okay. Don't become closed off, and don't allow your anxiety and your fears triggered by the past to block you. Alright. Ooh, bottom of the deck is the Reverse King of Wands. Okay, so maybe you were dealing with some kind of fire, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, strong Leo, Sagittarius energy though. You could have been dealing with, you know, if, like I said, if you were dealing with someone who was emotionally immature, somebody who left you out in the cold, somebody who broke your heart, it could have definitely been the Reverse King of Wands, because that is like, you know, somebody who's not the most reliable in a romantic context. You know, they value their freedom, they... It's just a player energy, okay? So, other than that, if it wasn't like a romantic relationship, it could have just been like a friend, somebody whose energy was too overbearing, too controlling, too hot-headed, any of those things. It's definitely an excessive, fiery energy that could have caused you this conflict, whether that is friendship or romantic or otherwise. But like I said, I do see something new on the horizon for you, where that's just a new path that you're taking, whatever it is. It looks very passionate, it looks exciting, it looks inspiring, and it looks like a breath of fresh air in regards to what you, in contrast to what you've been through here with this, you know, heavy, burdensome, you know, sorrowful energy. Do we have any closing messages or advice for Virgo? Closing messages, guidance for Virgo. That King of Pentacles, it did come out. I couldn't see whether it was in the reverse or the upright. I couldn't tell. But that's the only energy that really shows up is you, Virgo. Other than like the Queen of Swords, which if you go into the astrology of it, it could be Virgo slash Libra energy. But that King of Pentacles, I'm just going to read that in a positive way, because like I said, I didn't see how it fell out. So for some of you, that could just be talking about someone more stable on the horizon that you could be coming into contact with, whether that is a friend, whether that is a romantic relationship, or whether that's just a social connection that you'll make in order to help you, you know, build towards your goals or build towards your financial security or stability. Other than that, a lot of you could be stepping into the King of Pentacles energy yourself. Okay, somebody who's secure, who's stable, who's prosperous, whose ducks are in a row, and who is able to, you know, enjoy their life and enjoy the stability that comes with it. Do we have any closing advice, closing guidance? Adversity. I accept the challenges are the best way to learn. Like I said, I do feel like you guys have been through a lot of adversity. For some of you, you're still going through this, but yeah. Any more closing advice, divine guidance for Virgo? Oh my gosh, damn near every sign has gotten acceptance, accepting what you cannot change. Bottom of the deck is friendship. I understand that a friend is in my life for a reason, whether they last long term or not. Everyone in your life is there for a reason to teach you something. Like I said, I do feel like a lot of you have new connections, whether that's friendship or mental relationship, on the horizon for you, okay? Do I want to clarify some of these? We're at 18 minutes. Can we clarify adversity for Virgo? Okay. Six of Wands. Being successful in regards to triumphing or overcoming the adversity. Like I said, I do feel like you guys are moving away from this energy, or you're needing to work through this energy so that you can, once this cycle is done, you can just be done with it. You know, you don't have any extra issues to work out, and you're tying up loose ends. So like I said, being victorious over the adversity. All right. Clarify acceptance for Virgo. All right, the Reverse High Priestess. So accepting like the things that you've discovered about whoever or whatever this is. Okay. The Reverse High Priestess talks about secret. It can talk about gossip. It can talk about scandal, inappropriate behavior. It can talk about, you know, at one point maybe losing your voice and not being in touch with your intuition or your inner compass and overcoming that, but also accepting the things that have been revealed to you in regards to a person or a situation thus far. All right. Let me clarify friendships for Virgo. And then you want to come out now. We have the reverse seven of wands, the page of wands, and the reverse hermit. Your energy being in the reverse. So, like I said, for some of you, you could have been dealing with, like, immature people. Other than that, though, page of wands, like, exploring something new, something exciting, something inspiring, having a new lease on life. The reverse hermit is, you know, it can be somebody who feels lonely or who feels like they're on the outside looking in, but this is definitely somebody who is kind of, who could be coming out of hermit mode, you know, once again exploring something new, having a new lease on life, having fresh energy, being just being in a new space. Okay. And the reverse seven of wands, one, not fighting for a particular situation anymore, but also not feeling the need to be defensive and on guard anymore. So like I said, I do feel like a lot of you, after you overcome this energy, you will be stepping into just being more liberated, all right, and being able to enjoy yourself more. And like I said, new friendships, new connections. Is there anything else I want? So I want to get one card from this deck. Then I'll read a few. I'm surprised that this reading just flew by. We're only at 21 minutes. Any closing divine guidance, insight, messages, advice for Virgo? Hope. Okay. Bottom of the deck is gentleness. I will read what those mean, but hope is pretty self-explanatory. Like I said, not carrying this baggage with you into this next connection, friendship, romantic relationship, or this new path that you're going towards, okay? Gentleness, being gentle with yourself, being gentle with your process, not being harsh on yourself, not trying to force yourself not to feel what you feel or to be over whatever this is if that's not something that you're ready for. So let me see. Read adversity. I've never pulled this card before. So it says, I accept the challenge are the best way to learn. No one ever said life was going to be easy. Obstacles are presented to you so that you may overcome them. Believe that you will, because if you don't believe in yourself, no one else will. Confidence comes to those who have succeeded in conquering adversity, and then the next hurdle won't seem as daunting. Adversity is an opportunity for you to reach out to your soul family. You're not alone in this time of challenge. If you need help, others are waiting to offer you assistance. This test may have come into your life to teach you to receive rather than to give. Virgo, you can be the one who serves and serves to your own detriment, so that could be something that you need to balance so that you're not taking advantage of implementing necessary boundaries. Especially if you have a Virgo North Node, that is definitely a sign of needing to implement your boundaries, because with your Virgo North Node, that means that your South Node is in Pisces and that you can have issues with boundaries and being the martyr, being the victim, being taken advantage of. Okay, so definitely. If you have a lot of Virgo energy in your chart, or if you have a Virgo North Node, definitely boundaries, and the adversity was here to teach you boundaries. Okay. So, let me see. No, acceptance is so straightforward. It's literally accept things that you cannot change, because things are what they are, and people are who they are for a rhyme and for a reason, even if you don't understand that reason. It says, hope, hold on to hope when things feel hopeless. Change your outlook to feel hopeful. Trust in the magical flow of life and love. Mm-hmm. While it's important to acknowledge any pain and perhaps fear of the future combined with the feeling that hope is lost, it's equally important not to harbor these feelings for too long. Release them, knowing in your heart that hope can and will return again. Although it might feel that way, you're not at the mercy of your feelings and external circumstances. Each and every situation can be turned around so that you can recognize and nurture feelings of hope. Simply looking at things from another perspective can literally shine a new light on your life and bring hope to the forefront once again. So try focusing on the positive things in your life, not to, you know, be positive in a toxic way of avoidance, but just to, just so that you're not soaking in the lower vibrational feelings. You know, sometimes sadness, depression, sorrow, sometimes it can overtake your energy, and you need to be able to, you know, pull yourself out of it just so you don't sink deeper into it, all right? Because even though you have to feel the emotion, you don't need to get lost in those emotions. So that's basically what it's saying here. Open your heart to possibilities and miracles that a renewed sense of hope can bring. Right, it's gentleness, because then we'll be almost done. I have friendship to read next. Now it says, be gentle towards yourself and others at this time. Being harsh or using brute strength won't benefit you. There's great strength in gentleness, so... This card basically asks you, are you being gentle with yourself? It's easy to be critical and berate yourself. Our internal dialogue isn't always gentle, so this is something to be mindful of. If you catch yourself being harsh, then forgive yourself and try a softer internal narrative. You'll be surprised at the effect this can have on your general well-being. If there is a person who needs to treat you more gently, if so, speak your truth from the heart with kindness and clearly tell them how their approach makes you feel, and that a more gentle attitude would reap greater rewards for everyone. If not, then that's not an energy that really needs to be in your life. And last but not least is friendship. It says, I understand that a friend is in my life for a reason. All humans are created from the same source, but there are some souls that share a unique kinship. Friendship can be the most exciting, beautiful experience on earth, but it can also be frustrating and heartbreaking. Understand that everyone in your path is here to teach you something, and maybe for a year or a lifetime. Together you will teach each other various lessons of the heart, such as trust, love, loyalty, and admiration. The bonds of friendship can often be stronger than those of family. You have formed a bridge of understanding between the two of you that has stood the test of time and of lifetimes. A true friend will illuminate your path instead of dim it. He or she will give advice with your best interest at heart. To be able to communicate at a soul level with another human being is the biggest treasure of the physical dimension. So like I said, I do feel like, especially if this has been, like I said, a friendship or a romantic relationship where you've fallen out with people, you have a new one on the horizon, one that's more exciting, one that is more liberating, one that lets you be yourself, you know, one that brings you good energy. All right, so Virgo, I know you've been through a lot of shit, and for some of you, you're still going through it, and for that, my heart goes out to you. But remember to work through your feelings instead of running away from them. Remember to implement your boundaries. Remember to be gentle with yourself in your healing process. Quite a few readings have gotten cards where people are going through some heavy things, and they're needing to be gentle with themselves as well. So the same applies to you. Don't be too critical on yourself, alright, Virgo? Other than that, I love you, I appreciate you, and I will see you sooner rather than later in my next video. Let me see. Oh, I randomly pulled a card, and then it just says, enjoy the journey, acknowledge your progress, mental vacation, be spontaneous, travel, if that is something that you're able to do. So, thank you for watching, and I will see you.